Okay, so let's talk about getting set up. So these are the instructions for Java, the Java Software Development Kit, and TextPad. Okay, so installing Java SDK and TextPad. So TextPad's Windows only. If you're running a Mac or a Linux box or something like that, there's plenty of other editors you can choose. For example, there's BlueJ and all sorts of other ones, NetBeans, Eclipse. If you're running anything else other than Windows, I'd probably select Eclipse as the IDE, as your development environment, okay? But this video is about setting up TextPad, so I want to just talk about TextPad here. So just some full disclosure. I'm using TextPad because this is recommended editor for the Java courses I teach. I've been teaching them for a long time, and this is the recommended editor. And it's super fast, super simple, super lightweight. It's very easy to install and set up. It doesn't have a lot of mucking around. It doesn't have a million knobs and bells and whistles to tweak. It does everything I need for the vast majority of the projects I do, and I like it. So that's why I'm using TextPad. If you don't want to use TextPad, use something else. That's okay. Use whatever you're happy with. Okay, so the installation consists of three steps. There's three steps, okay? The first one is to download the Java SE Software Development Kit, or the Java SDK. Okay, and that's the link you need. The link will be in the description under the video. Okay, and that takes you to this page. And the first thing you'll need to do is sign in. You can't download any of these now without signing into Oracle. Okay, so let's do a sign in. I've already set up my account. And I'm Moose Software, so I've set up my account already. Okay, and once you do that, now you can download. So if you haven't created an Oracle account, let's go through the account creation process. It'll send you out an email. You'll have to click a link to activate your account, all the usual stuff. Okay, and then what you do is you just scroll down and you'll choose the JDK. Okay, and if unless you're running the old version of TextPad like I am, if you're going to run the latest version of TextPad, I would suggest probably downloading the latest Java. So download Java 13. We'll talk about troubleshooting later. Okay, so download the JDK, and it'll take you to another screen, and you click accept. You've got to click that accept button there, that radio button. Accept the license agreement, and that activates the links. And now you can choose the right JDK for your platform. So if you're a Windows user, you would choose this one. It's Windows 64 only. Windows 32-bit's no longer supported. So if you've got a Windows 32-bit machine you're doing this work on, you'll need to scroll down and download one of the earlier versions of Java, maybe Java 7. Okay, this is Java 13. Okay, so you click that, and that will download the installer. Or if you're running Linux, you can download one of those there, or grab it doing a sudo apt-get or whatever you do to install your software. It's many, many ways to do stuff. Okay, for Windows users, you download that one. Okay, the exe, and that will download it to your machine into your downloads folder. You'll navigate to that downloads folder, you'll run the exe and go through the installation process. Basically just go through a bunch of dialogues going next, 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 and eventually it might take about 3 or 4 minutes. You'll finish the installation process for Java SDK, and that installs the Java runtime and the Java Software Development Kit. So you can run Java programs and develop them on this machine now. Okay, so that's Java. Once you've got Java installed, you can go on to step two. So install Java SDK, first step. Step two is to download and install TextPad. And there's a link there for TextPad. It'll be in the description under the video. Okay, and so you'll come to a screen like this, TextPad, and click the download link, and click TextPad 8 downloads. It's the latest version at this stage, and it will take you here. So choose the language version you want, and you've downloaded the, if you've downloaded the 64-bit version of the Java SDK, and you're running Windows 64, Windows 10 64 for example, then download the 64-bit version of TextPad. Okay, if you're English, or it's French or German or whatever, there's the language options there. Okay, so if you downloaded the 64-bit version of the Java SDK and installed that, download the 64-bit version of TextPad so the bit versions match up properly. Okay. Run the installer and follow the prompts, and that should be it. You should be ready to go. Now there's a couple of little tweaks I'll suggest, and I'm not sure about these, just some full disclosure. I'm not sure if you still have to do these tweaks, but I do on my old version. So I'll just show them to you anyway. I'll show you the tweaks I do, and then you can decide whether you want to do them or not, or whatever. Okay, so in TextPad, you go up to the View menu, and you turn line numbers on. So just make sure that that's got a little tick there. If it's not ticked, just select it, and it'll put the tick there automatically. And then you get the line numbers here on the side, which is very useful. Okay. Another one I like to do is to change my shortcuts. You might not need to do this on the latest version, like I said, but on my version I did, my old version of TextPad. I bought it about 15 years ago, and I'm still using that old version, 10, 15 years ago, whatever it was. I can't remember. Okay, so you configure Preferences Editor. Configure Preferences Editor. And then I've changed my keystroke compatibility. I think it defaults to TextPad. I've changed mine to Microsoft Applications. Okay. What that gives you, it means you get Ctrl+C is copy, Ctrl+V is paste, Ctrl+F is find, all the usual shortcuts from Word and Excel and everything, then apply to TextPad, which is nice. The one thing that does do though, is it turns off your shortcuts for compiling and running Java programs, which is a little bit annoying, but they're really easy to enable again. So once you've done steps 1 and 2, you should better come here and go Tools, External Tools, and it should be Compile and Run. There should be these two commands here. There might be others as well, but there should be at least those two. Okay. If they're not there, you can go Configure, Preferences, Tools, and then up here, when those aren't there, the Compile and Run, there'll be an option here saying Add the Java Software Development, the Java Compile Run commands. There'll be an option there if they're not there already. Okay. But that should all be done automatically for you. The only thing we need to do is now set up our keyboard shortcuts. So we want Ctrl+1 to be compile, Ctrl+2 to be run. Okay, so configure, preferences. And again, things might have moved around slightly in your version. So we're talking about keyboard here. We're talking about items on the tools menu. We're talking about compile. And what you'll do is you'll click on that box there and go Ctrl+1. And then go assign. But I've already assigned it, so I won't do it again. And then click on the run box, click in there and go Ctrl+2 and click assign. But I've already done it, so I don't need to do it again. Okay, and that's about it. So just turn the hotkeys on for Ctrl+1, Ctrl+2 to compile and run your Java. And turn on line numbers so that you can see where you are in your program, so that you can match yourself up with what I'm doing on videos, and you should be good to go. Okay, they're the main two tweaks that I do. Just a bit of full disclosure. So on the date this video is recorded, I'm still using Java 8, and I'm using an old 32-bit version. On my Windows 10 64-bit machine, I'm running Java 8, which is really old now. It's probably 3 or 4 years old, and I'm running the 32-bit version. Why am I doing that? Because I've developed a lot of software, and there's a little issue I'm having when I move on to later versions of Java, and I need to just spend half a day trying to fix that. So before I can move on, I'm still running the old version of Java. Does everything I need, so why move on? And I'm running TextPad 5.4, which is really old. I think the latest version of TextPad is TextPad 8 something, so my TextPad's very old. It's 10 plus years old. But the latest versions of TextPad and Java SDK should work fine for you. Okay, so give that a try, see how you go. Install the SDK, download and install the SDK, download and install TextPad, turn line numbers on. If you want to change your hotkey so you match up with what Windows normally does, change it if you want. And then you might need to reassign your hotkeys to compile and run the Java applications, and I'll show you how to do that. And that's it. So it's pretty simple to set up. A little bit of troubleshooting. So the first thing you do if you're having problems is check all of the comments and all of the replies below the video and see if anyone else had the same problem and see how it's been fixed and see what's been suggested. Okay, that's number one. You can also go to the... You can also turn on your, go to Configure, Preferences, like I showed you earlier, go to Tools, and if any of those compile and run there already, there will be an option here saying Add the Java Compile and Run commands. So that's something you might need to do. Sometimes TextPad doesn't pick it up properly, and some people have had to do that. Okay, the other thing you need to do is make sure you've got matching versions. So if you've got Windows 64, download the 64-bit versions of both TextPad and the SDK. So make sure you've downloaded and installed both those. If you're running a 32-bit version of Windows, make sure you download the 32-bit version of the Java SDK and TextPad. So you might need to go back to a really early version of Java, maybe Java 8, maybe Java 7. Okay. You might need to go back to an old version of TextPad, maybe TextPad's 5, like I am running. I'm still running the 32-bit version of TextPad, and so on. If you're still having problems, if you still can't get things to work, install the 32-bit versions of the Java SDK. So you might need to go back to Java 7, Java 8 to find a 32-bit version, because it's support for 32-bit versions stopped around that time. And then install TextPad. Okay, and if you still have problems, you can install an old, say Java 8 or Java 7 32-bit version, and then an old TextPad 5 point something's a good one. That's what I'm using. And if you still have problems, then use your favorite internet search engine. Okay, so type the error message into Google or whatever and do a search and see what you can find out. Okay, so there's some troubleshooting anyway. I don't think you'll have any problems. TextPad's been great for me. It's very rare people have problems, so you probably won't have to do any troubleshooting at all. So, just to recap, install the SDK, the Java SDK. Okay, so download the installer. It's about 180 megabytes or 200 megabytes, somewhere around there, and then install it. It'll take about 2 or 3 minutes to install. Then download and install TextPad. So install the SDK, install TextPad, turn line numbers on if they're not on already. If you want to change your compatibility so that the keys work the same as all other Windows applications, follow these steps here. Okay, so it's pretty easy stuff. Okay, so hope that was useful. Thanks for watching.